Hello everyone, in this video I will go over my solution to the problem named carousal. This problem is taken from Code Forces round 629 and is rated 1800. This problem is an interesting problem on coloring in graphs. So first I'll explain the two key ideas which this problem tests. Then I'll explain the problem statement and the three-step solution to this problem, and finally we will look at the code. So the two key ideas which this problem is testing you on is, the first idea is that you need to be able to create and use a graph from the input which does not have a graph. And it actually turns out that the graph is undirected and simple. And the second key idea which this problem is testing you on is finding the minimum number of colors in this undirected and simple graph such that any two adjacent nodes don't have the same color. So now that we understand the two ideas behind the solution for this problem, let's look at the problem statement. In this problem, we are given a carousal consisting of n figures of animals. The figures are numbered from 1 to n. And the carousal is basically a circle in which the nth figure is followed by the first figure. Each figure has its own type, which basically is the type of the animal in that figure or corresponding to that figure. So we are given an array of n integers which represent the type of the ith animal in the carousal. And we want to color each figure with one of the colors. And the condition is that there should be no two adjacent figures which have the same color. So what we need to do is, we need to output the minimum number of colors to color each of the figure in the n figures such that this condition is met. And basically we need to print the valid coloring with k colors. And obviously the colors will be integers from 1 to k. So we are given q independent test cases. For each test case, we are given n, the number of figures. And this is a circle, so the nth figure goes after the first figure. And we are given the types of the animals in that carousal. And we need to output the minimum number of distinct colors which meets this condition. Let's look at the three-part solution to this problem before we apply the ideas in the sample test cases. So the solution turns out to be very simple. It's just three steps. The first step is that since we know that any two adjacent figures which do not have the same type of animal, which have distinct types of animals, need to be painted with different colors, so they can't be colored with the same color, let's build a graph which represents this information. So let's build a graph and we draw an edge between the indices I and I plus 1 if the animal types are different. So if the animal types are different and they are adjacent to each other, then we draw an edge connecting them, and this means that the indices I and I plus 1 need to be colored with different colors. Then the second thing is to notice is that this is a round table, so there should also be an edge between 1 and n. Here we are just adding an edge between 1 and 2 and 2 and 3 and all the way up to 8 and 9, but there should also be an edge between 1 and n. So this is the second step. Draw an edge between 1 and n if they are different animals. And the third is that we need to find the minimum number of colors to color so that every node in this new graph which we have created are assigned different colors. So every two adjacent nodes, any two adjacent nodes, need to be colored with different colors in the graph which we have created. So this is the idea behind the three-step solution. So let's apply this idea to solve the sample test case. So there are five sample test cases. I'll be looking at sample test case 2 and 3, and you should be able to figure out the solution for the other two sample test cases. So in the sample test case 2, we are given 6 integers, and the types of the animals for the 6 numbers are written in this array. And as I mentioned in the 3-part solution, we would draw an edge between any two adjacent nodes or adjacent indices which have a different color. So how this first graph would look like would be, there's an edge between 1 and 2 because they are different. There's no edge between 2 and 3. There's an edge between 3 and 4. There's an edge between 4 and 5. And there's an edge between 5 and 1 because these are adjacent nodes which have different types of animals. And now let's try to color every node in this graph such that adjacent nodes have different colors. So let's say we start from the node 1 and color it with a number 1. Then we notice that node 2 should be colored with a different color, let's say color 2. Then node 5 should also be colored with a different color, so let's say color 2, because node 5 is adjacent to color 1, I mean to node 1. Then the adjacent node to 5, which is 4, should be colored with color 1. And the adjacent node to node 4, which is node 3, should be colored with color 2. And you can verify that this is one of the possible answers. So the answer will be that only two colors are required, and this is one of the possible answers, or even this will be acceptable. For the next sample test case, we are given 5 numbers, and these are the types of the animals for those 5 numbers. And this is the graph which is created. So we apply the same process for any two adjacent nodes which have a different type of animal. We'll draw an edge between them. And in this case, between all pairs of adjacent indices, the colors are different. That's why all the adjacent indices have been linked together, including 5 to 1. And again, let's apply the same process of coloring every node so that we make sure that the adjacent nodes don't have the same color. So we start with node 1, and then we color node 2 and 5 the opposite color of node 1. Then we color 3 and 4 the opposite color because they are adjacent to 2 and 5. But the problem is that 3 and 4 get the same color. Hence, what we actually need to do is that we need to assign 4 a different color. So let's say red, and let's name that color 3. So what actually happens is that node 4 will get a color 3 and the other nodes will get colors from 1 to 2. And this would be one of the valid answers. So even in this case, you can see that case 3, we need at least 3 colors so that every two adjacent nodes get a different color. And these are the second and third sample test cases. So now, as you can see, we have reduced the problem to finding the minimum number of colors to color every node in the graph such that any two adjacent nodes are colored with different colors. So first, let's make some observations about the graph. So the graph is actually simple, undirected, and every node has 0 or 1 or 2 adjacent nodes. These two properties of the graph, that is simple and undirected, are very important. They are the key ideas behind how we can construct a solution. This is not that important. This you can observe from the fact that we connect edges from a node to adjacent nodes only. So the third property, which is not that important, is true because we are drawing edges from an index I to an index I minus 1 or I plus 1 only. And hence you can see that the number of adjacent nodes can only be 0, 1 or 2. But let's try to arrive at a solution based on the fact that we have given an undirected and simple graph. So let's make some further key observations. The first idea which should have come to your mind is that if the graph is bipartite, then two colors suffice. And this should be obvious from the previous videos because that's exactly what we have been doing. We have been looking at bipartite graphs which are two colorable. And now let's think of the general case when the graph is not bipartite. And what you really need to understand or think about more for yourself is that actually three colors are enough. And the reason why that is true is because whenever we get a discrepancy, as in this graph, we just assign a third color to that node and everything turns out to be okay. So that's the key idea behind the whole solution. If we find that the graph is not bipartite, add a third color. So let's consider the implementation. In the implementation, we would do the normal DFS for bipartite graphs. But if we get a discrepancy, or if we get a node which is already colored with the same color, then assign a third color to the invalid node or the node which is causing the problem in the DFS. So this is the whole idea behind the solution. So we run the normal DFS. The moment when we check that the two colors of adjacent nodes are the same, we just assign a third color to one of those two adjacent nodes. So basically, whenever we realize that two adjacent nodes have the same color in the DFS, then we assign a third color to one of those two adjacent nodes. And this will basically solve the problem in the case when the graph is not bipartite. So let's just implement the same idea. So in the implementation, first I'll create a global variable n, which is the number of different nodes in the graph. And I'll also have an adjacency list, and I'll have a visited array, and I'll have the colors of the nodes. Now, for each test case, I'll call a solve function, and before that I'll call a function which basically creates the graph after reading in the input. So first let's write the function create graph. It takes in the number n and it takes in the array of t integers, which basically stores the types of each animal. So for each I from I to n, I'll take in the input and then I'll basically create the graph. But one thing to notice is that since we are solving for t independent test cases, we need to basically reinitialize all the values. So we need to clear the adjacency list of each node. We need to mark each node as not visited, and we need to assign a color of -1 to that node, like we did in the previous problems. Then we take in each value of the type of the animal. And as I mentioned, if the current animal and the next animal are of different types, then I'll need to add an edge from I to I plus 1. And I'll also add an edge from I plus 1 to I, because the graph is undirected. So now that I have created the graph, I just need to check for one special case, which is basically if t of 1 is not equal to t of n, then I'll basically add an edge from 1 to n. And this corresponds to the second part of our three-part solution. The third part is the DFS. So that was the first part, which is creating the first part of the graph. Then this was creating the second part of the graph. And now let's do the DFS. So in the DFS, first I'll call the DFS function on each unvisited node. And before I call the DFS, I need to assign the colors as usual. So in this case, the colors are 1, 2, or 3. And we'll opt for 1 and 2. Whenever we get a discrepancy, that time we'll assign the color 3. So now the DFS function is the main function which we are concerned with, because that implementation will be slightly different. The first thing which we do is we mark visited of u to be 1. Then for all adjacent nodes, if we realize that the colors are the same, so basically we got a discrepancy, then we basically set color of u to be 3. And we can also set color of v to be 3. But in this case, I chose color of u to be 3. You can code it the other way around and that should also get accepted. And then basically we'll continue because we know that v was visited. If v is not visited, then we'll call a DFS on v, and before that we'll just assign a color to v. So in the color assignment, if color of u is 1, then we can set color of v to be 2. Otherwise, if color of u is 2, we can set color of v to be 1. Otherwise, we know that the color of u is 3, and hence we can set any color. Set color of v to be 1 or 2, it doesn't really matter, because 1 and 2 are the same when the color of u is 3. And then we launch the DFS from v, and there's no Boolean DFS because we know that the graph will be colored with either 1, 2 or 3 colors. And now that we have launched the DFS, we just output the colors. So what we do is, for each I from 1 to n, just print the color of I and just print the endl or the new line. But we also need to output the number of colors, and this is going to be done in the following way. So the answer is that there's going to be at least one color, and for all the other nodes we find the maximum color, so find the max color number used in the coloring. So once we find the max color number used, that is actually going to represent the number of colors. So this is how we'll write the code. In this case, I actually didn't have a solve function, so I'll remove that. I just created the graph, and in the same place I had written the whole code. So I had made a small mistake in which I had set color of 1 to be 1 instead of color of I to be 1, and now the code is giving the correct output. So I'll just submit this code to see that it gets accepted. As you could see, my code got accepted. I hope you like this problem and my solution to this problem. As you could see, this problem illustrated the idea of creating a graph on your own from the input and then applying the coloring strategy, or finding the minimum number of colors required to color every node in that graph so that any two adjacent nodes don't have the same color. In the next few videos, I'll be covering similar concepts related to depth first search. So do join me over there. If you like the video, don't forget to give it a thumbs up and do consider subscribing to my channel for more such content. Thank you.